Two high-profile Supreme Court lawyers, allegations of corruption and raids by the CBI. That is the top headline to which the country woke up today morning. And the lawyers are none other than Indira Jai Singh and her husband Anand Grover. Hello everybody, this is Ishwar. You're watching QRAP. And the CBI today raided the Delhi and Mumbai residences of Indira Jai Singh and Anand Grover over allegations of violation of the FCRA and the Anti-Corruption Act. Indira Jai Singh, in a statement given to the media for human rights over the past few years. We have the Quint's legal editor, Vakasha Sachdev, joining us. Vakasha, what exactly are the allegations against Indira Jai Singh and Anand Grover?
So, Jai Singh and Grover are both co-founders of an organization called Lawyers Collective. It's an NGO which does a lot of sort of advocacy work, organizes meetings and produces a lot of literature about, you know, big ticket sort of human rights and public interest issues across the country. Now, that organization has received foreign donations over the years, which means they had to be registered under the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act, which restricts who can receive foreign money and what they can do with it. Now, what the Ministry of Home Affairs has alleged after raids which were conducted back in 2016, so this is January 2016, they made allegations that these guys violated the FCRA because they were using money which they received for foreign donations for reasons which were not identified in their objects and reasons which were registered with the government. So they said, oh, they're doing work on HIV AIDS awareness or women's empowerment awareness, which is not part of what they said. They said that Grover has used money which was given to them as part of for objectives which were not part of it. For instance, he was a UN special rapporteur on the right to health. They say that work which he did on the Novartis case, where he represented a bunch of cancer patients who were trying to stop. So these were things for which money had been received by the organization. They said this should never have happened. She was additional Solicitor General of India for around 5 years. I think it was 2009 to 2014. They say she received remuneration from Lawyers Collective for work which she did for them at that time, which was wrong because, you know, a government servant at that time. And they've also argued that, you know, she shouldn't have been traveling abroad, and neither should she or Grover have ever traveled abroad on this kind of money. So it's a number. There's 14 observations which the Ministry of Home Affairs made. Those 14 observations are basically regurgitated into a complaint in May this year by the Ministry of Home Affairs, and the CBI then took it up. Now, those allegations are been at play sitting in the Bombay High Court for the last several years, because it was on this basis that their FCRA license was cancelled. So that's also been challenged. So that's where things are at this moment, and now we have the raids.
Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has also alleged that this is a vendetta against them. Now, what is the way forward for Indira Jai Singh and Anand Grover in this case, considering the possibility of them having to get out of this mess?
So, I mean, the allegations of a vendetta come out of the fact that this whole case resurfaced only in May, because May 6th, basically someone filed a petition in the Supreme Court, an organization called Lawyers Voice, which has got a lot of BJP members as who are lawyers who are part of it. Now, they filed a petition raising this whole question of FCRA again, even though for 3 years the CBI had done nothing, the Ministry of Home Affairs and CBI had done nothing. And then magically within 6 days, the FIR was registered and so now that's what they're saying, that, you know, look, this is where this obviously shows that it's a vendetta. They now have two options. Either they can move to directly get this FIR quashed, so they can approach the Supreme Court or the Delhi Bombay High Courts to get that done. Or they could try and say, let's try and get the Bombay High Court decision to move along. Because if that moves along and, you know, their FCRA license cancellation is quashed, that quashes straight away a lot of these, would quash these observations. So that's their two options at this point. They probably would make sense for them to also just approach the Supreme Court anyway at this point to get this quashed. You know, that Lawyers Voice petition is still being heard. You've got the Bombay High Court proceedings, and now you've got this, you know, there'll be proceedings over this FIR. So the logical step would probably be to try and get them all merged into one hearing in either of the Delhi or Bombay High Courts or in the Supreme Court.
So how things go for Indira Jai Singh and Anand Grover after the CBI raids? Now moving on to another update, another top headline from Uttar Pradesh. I am not wearing sindoor for fashion, I'm actually married. This was the message sent by Sakshi Mishra to her father and BJP MLA from Betkar Chainpur, Rajesh Mishra, after she married a Dalit man, reportedly against her family's wishes. In a video that she posted on social media, she alleged that there are goons paid by the family and her father who might harm her and her husband. Here is the video and the allegations that Sakshi has leveled. Take a look.
And this is my husband, Abhi. We have married our own marriage. अब मेरे घर वाले जो हैं वो उन्होंने मतलब लोगों को पीछा लगा दिया है हमारे, और हम भागते भागते बहुत परेशान हो चुके हैं, और बस मैं बरेली के कप्तान से यही रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहूँगी कि वो हमारी प्रोटेक्शन के लिए सिक्योरिटी दें और हमारा ख्याल रखें।
Her father, in the meanwhile, has refuted the allegations leveled by Sakshi, his daughter, and said that she is an adult and is free to make her own choices. He has also said that nobody related to him or the party or anybody associated with him is responsible for the threats that Sakshi is getting. We are tracking those updates for you on the Quince website, but for now, moving on to Karnataka, where the political crisis is still underway. The Supreme Court today ordered the rebel MLAs of the Congress and the JDS to submit their resignations again by 6 p.m. to the Speaker, and also ordered the Speaker to take a decision on the resignations before midnight. This order was challenged by the Speaker in a petition that he had filed, but it was not entertained by the Supreme Court. And a similar situation unfolded in Goa last night after 10 of their MLAs resigned and joined the BJP. Now, with this development, Goa has gone down to 5, while the BJP's tally in the state has gone up to 27. To remind our viewers, Pramod Sawant was recently made Chief Minister after the death of Manohar Parikar, and him, along with a few MLAs who joined the BJP today, also met Rajnath Singh and BJP Working President JP Nadda. We are also tracking updates from Goa and Karnataka for you on the Quince website, so stay tuned. But for now, the Ayodhya Ram Janmabhoomi case has made headlines again, because the Supreme Court today said that the mediation committee led by Justice Kalifullah, if it cannot come up with a status in July giving a clear verdict on the matter, then the case will be heard by the Supreme Court from the 25th of July on a daily basis. We are tracking all those updates for you as well on the Quince website, Facebook, YouTube and Twitter, so stay tuned. But for now, it's the weekend, and this week's big release is Hrithik Roshan's Super 30, a movie that tells the story of Anand Kumar, a brilliant mathematician who helps 30 underprivileged children prepare for the IIT entrances. So should you or should you not watch the film? Watch RJ Stuti's review.
The film I'm going to be reviewing today is Super 30. And let's admit it, the main reason why we are so excited is because it has Hrithik Roshan. But when you film dekhkar wapas aaoge na, you'll be praising only the other 30 super actors. If you've been following the promotions, to aapko pata hai, Super 30 is based on the true, very inspiring story of Anand Kumar.
Well, you can catch that full review on the Quince website, Facebook, YouTube and Twitter. That's all on today's Q-Rap, but tomorrow we will be back with more headlines of the day. Tab tak ke liye, thank you. Namaskar. This is Ishwar signing off.